Hi students, 11th standard, Computer Science and Computer Application, Chapter 4, Theoretical Concepts of Operating System. In this video, we are going to learn about some features of operating system. Now, let us start. The first one is memory management. So, it is the process of controlling and coordinating computer's main memory and assigning memory blocks. Here, block means it's a space to various running programs to optimize overall computer performance. So, for computer performance, we allocate the space for various process. So, the memory management involves the allocation of a specific memory block to individual programs based on the user needs. So, the objective of memory management process is to improve both the utilization of CPU and computer's response to its user through main memory. For these reasons, the computer must keep programs in main memory and then that associates with many different memory schemes. And then next, the operating system is responsible for the following activities. That is, the first one, keep tracking on which portion of memory are currently being used and who is using. So, which memory is currently used and who is using. And second, it determines which processes and data to move in and out of memory. So, which processes process to move in and out of memory. And next one, allocation and deallocation of memory blocks as needed by the program in memory. So, allocation and deallocation. We allocate for a particular job, any job. If we process a job, we need to allocate the space. So, the allocation and deallocation of memory block are as needed by the program in main memory. So, these are all the memory management. The next one, process management. It is a function. It includes creating and deleting processes, that is a program. Creating and deleting the processes, or we can call it as a programs, and providing mechanism for process to communicate and synchronize with each other. So, we can communicate and synchronize with each other. A system task like sending output to a printer, a screen can also be called as process. So, process means we give any work to the system. For example, we send the output to printer or screen. That is called process. And a computer consists of a collection of processes. They are classified into two categories. So, the process is divided into two categories. One is operating system processes, which is executed by system code. One is executed by system code. And another one is user processes, which is executed by user code. It executes by user code. So, all these processes can potentially execute concurrently on a single CPU. We can run in a single CPU. Now, let us see some of the algorithms that are mainly used to allocate the job to the processor. So, we have four algorithms. The first one is FIFO. That is first in, first out. The first one is FIFO and second one SJF, that is shortest job first. And third one is a round robin. And fourth one, based on priority. So the four types of the four algorithms is mainly used to allocate the job. The first one, FIFO, that is first in, first out. So this algorithm is based on queuing technique. So this algorithm is based on queuing technique. That is, for example, a student is standing in a queue, that is a row, to get a rank card or from his teacher, his or her teacher. So the other students who stand first in the queue get a grade sheet first and leave from the queue. So they're followed by a next student in the queue and get it corrected and so on. So this is the basic logic of FIFO, that is first in, first out. So technically, the process that enters the queue first is executed first by the CPU. So which process is giving first? It executed by first and followed by next and so on. So the processes are executed in order of the queue. So that is FIFO, first in, first out method. And second one, SJF, that is shortest job first. So here, this algorithm is based on the size of the job it's being executed. It is based on size of job. So for example, if a job A has 6 kilobyte and job B 3 kilobytes. So it process first job B will be assigned, then job A will be gets continued. So here we do shortest job first. So based on a size, which one is the higher, slowest priority, it do that work first. And third one, round robin. So here round robin means it is RR scheduling algorithm is designed especially for time sharing system. So it is mainly designed for time sharing system. So here the job, that is any process, are assigned and the processor time in a circular method. So we follow in a circular method. For example, if we have job A, B, C, so first it process job A, then job B, after that job C. So it process in a round way. And next one is based on priority. So here the given job is assigned based on priority. So the job which has higher priority is more important than the other jobs. So it is based on a higher priority. So for example, take two jobs, job A and job B. So just you assume that job A has 5 and job B 7. So it works. First job B is assigned to the processor. After that, job A is processed, assigned for the job. So here, this is the method for based on priority. So it takes with the highest priority. So these are all the algorithms used in process management. First in, first out is a queuing technique. And second, SJF, shortest job first. And third one, round robin. It follows a circular method. And based on priority, so which one have highest priority, it processed that job first. Fault tolerance. So here, the operating system should be robust. So here, it means strong. So when there is a fault, the operating system should not crash. Instead of the operating system have fault tolerance, capability, and retain the existing state of the system. So this is fault tolerance. And next one is file management. Here, file management is the important function in operating system. So it is the important function in operating system. It handles the data storage technique. So the operating system manages the files, folders and directory system on a computer. So the generally we use FAT. So FAT means file allocation table. It stores the general information. It stores some general information about the file, that is size, type, time, etc. It stores the general address and accessing mode, either read or write mode, everything. So, the file manager of operating system helps to create, edit, copy, allocate the memory to files and also update the FAT, that is file allocation table. So, there are few other file management techniques also available, that is NTFS. There is a next generation file system and EXT2, that is Linux. And next one is multiprocessing. So here multiprocessing means it is also one of the feature in operating system. It has a two or more jobs. It has a two or more jobs for a single running process, that is a process takes a place in parallel, is called parallel processing. The execution takes place in parallel. So this feature is used for high speed execution, which increase the power of computing. So here multiprocessing means we can perform two or more processes for a single running process, that is a job. Time sharing. So it is one of the important feature in operating system. It allow execution of multiple tasks or process concurrently. So at the same time we can do many work, and then for each task a fixed time is allocated. So this division of time is called time sharing. So each task, it allocate a particular time. So the process switches rapidly between a various processes. After a time, it elapsed or the process is completed. For example, just you assume that three processes, that is P, process 1, process 2 and process 3. Here each process is 30 minutes, 40 minutes and 50 minutes. Here the first, if process P1 completes within 20 minutes, if it complete, it works within 20 minutes, then the process takes to the next process, that is P2, for the execution. If the process P2 couldn't complete within 14 minutes, it passed the current work and after that it switch over to the process P3. So it passed that work, then it continued this work. After completing this work, again it continued with the process 2. So this is the method of time sharing. We can divide a time and we can work it. Thank you, students.